Aristotle once said, "Everything grows old under the power of time and is forgotten through the lapse of time." However, I will never forget 1997. I remember the day they began tearing down the old stadium. I was coming home from school, and though it was over 20 years ago, that day and the memories of that season are still crystal clear in my mind. The Warriors played for the national championship, and though they lost, that team set the vision for the championships that were won later.
And I've been waiting for this moment for all my life.
This time, following one series by Manhattan, Showalter wide open. Dumas.
It's been a privilege for us to be here.
They are the third team ever to win three or more Division III.
Well, you told me you were drowning. I would not lend a hand.
I can see that first coin toss at home, and then the defense and special teams took over.
Clock on the scoreboard is official, as is the 25-second clock. So that's what you want to keep your eye on for the 25-second count. Wait, you're the visiting team. You're going to call the coin for me. It's a 50-cent piece. Call it in the air. If I drop it off, flip it again.
Hey.
Any called heads? It is a head. You have won the toss. You want to receive, which will be defense. Put your back up there. White steps this way. White wins the toss.
Delaware Valley has won the toss. They have elected to receive.
Hey, guys, make sure your coach is good. We've got 5 minutes to kick off.
Oh!
remember, time never ran out on our offense. Words of the players still echo that season.
My thoughts about the coaching staff this season, they were terrific. They were probably the best coaching staff I've ever experienced. On defense, Coach Wise, and he just put so much time in, and Coach Schlecky and Coach G, and they all just put so much time in. They're great with everybody. They're like more like friends to everybody, and I mean, they just know exactly what they're doing. They let us do what we have to do, and it just works out perfect.
The coaching staff, there's a lot to say about them. They're great, and there's a wide variety. I have Coach, the head coach, who's like calm and collective, and Frankie, who's all fired up, him and Jerry, and even Wise is like that, and Mickey, McMantle, he's bare, like, trying to calm us down, keep us in line and everything. So, I mean, you got a whole variety of spectrum there, of characters, and I think that's what you need to get along with us, because we got everyone on the team, clowning around or something. So I think if we fit together and work nicely together, and I think that's an important part.
They're all crazy. They're all nuts. No, it's good that they're crazy, though, because we're all a little bit crazy, and, it takes a little to control that, so it's good.
Our coaches here are great. Defensively, I know our coaches put in a great amount of time during the season. We work very hard with films and meetings, and I honestly don't think they're home as much as they're either at their jobs or at practice and meetings at school here. We work very hard all week long in game preparation, and our coaches are great. I think Coach Girardi does a real good job of coaching our personalities. We have a real bunch of characters on this team, and he knows how to handle us, and Coach Weiser himself is a character, and he does a great job firing us up and getting us motivated, and all the coaches are great. They're just as unique as the players are.
For the third straight time, the team made the Division III playoffs after finishing the sixth undefeated regular season in Warrior history.
And that's the way I want you to be. I want you to be in a controlled state of hysteria. Yeah.
Yeah. I'll tell you this right now. We're going to go normal, which means Monday, we lift, we watch tape. Everything is going to be normal, okay? Fellas, I couldn't say enough about you guys.
Let's go, baby.
Right, win it up, Joe. Yeah, like home. Bring home next week, baby. Defend the South.
The key word, you know, we could say that we would want to be remembered in 20 years would be a team that we were probably the closest family, you know, besides, you know, my own family at home. This is, you know, the biggest family that I've got. And just to come out with, you know, 60, 80 guys or whatever every weekend, and, you know, you go out and, you know, you play to death for each other, you know, you just really can't put anything on top of that.
Yeah. I'd also like to, you know, thank all my teammates and coaching staff. You know, I have a lot of memories, you know, from all 4 years here. You know, good luck next year. You know, you guys deserve everything you win, so I'll see you next year.
20 years from now, I'd hope we'd be remembered as a team that can come back from any sort of adversity that we'd face. There are a lot of times we were down this year. For instance, in the Rowan game, 20-0 at halftime, and you know, I think that was a key characteristic of this team.
20 years from now, I don't know. I think we have a lot of different players on this team, a lot of different personalities, and we stuck together throughout the whole year, and we made it to where we were supposed to be. And I think that I would like us just remembered as, you know, the team that stuck together through thick and thin.
We want to show them what Mid-Atlantic Conference football is like. We want to show them what Northern football is like.
Snorehouse, baby.
Right? And that's exactly right. You're at our place, baby.
Thank you.
We'll work on that stuff on Monday. We'll get ready to go Tuesday and Wednesday. Thursday, I tell you what, students are going to be back next week. The place is going to be a madhouse.
Yeah.
It's going to be a madhouse. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Number of people, our offense, I mean, you were great today. Defensively, came up with a big play. Special teams came up with a big play. Brian Thompson, the all-time leading rusher.
Wow, I think I used to joke around that I wasn't coming back because I wanted to play in the old stadium one more year. Because, you know, you played in it for 3 years. It's kind of going to be different tradition.
Being the last team to play in the old stadium, I think that's special to us, you know, especially to the seniors because, you know, the history of Lycoming, all the great football players that we've had, there's a lot of nostalgia. And, you know, to be the last team to play in that field and to go undefeated on the field our senior year, you know, that was special.
I think closing out the old stadium was just a great feeling for the seniors especially. We had played there our whole career, and we have great memories, great tradition at Lycoming, especially at that field. And, you know, we won't miss the cold showers or anything like that. But I don't know. I kind of would like to come back and see what the stadium will look like next year and just see how it is. We have a blue room, which is for the seniors and the starters and guys like that. And I think the blue room was very special to our program and our team, and I think that's what I'll miss most about the old stadium.
Well, the old stadium for me meant a lot, especially this season, because since I've been here, we had never lost a game in that stadium, and the young guys haven't either. So, and for the seniors, it's especially important because, I mean, just leaving here, they always want to get out of here on a good note, and that stadium's been real good to a lot of people, and it's been great tradition playing here and having all the old guys come back. And, you know, they played in the same stadium, and it's just great to be a part of that.
Let's go. Well, the fight like Cummings Prowess, Peter and the Prowess have superior offensive and defensive personnel.
You're right.
Now that's enough. Enough. You've come this far on a lot of talent and a lot of heart. One thing that Derby Scabby is the heart of this football team. That's what Derby Scabby is, the heart of this football team. Those boys are coming up here to play in our place. Let's take it up!
I think the biggest memory, no doubt, is the Rowan game. I mean, first half, I mean, we played actually terrible football. And then just to come back the second half and score 20 points, I mean, this goes to show, you know, how close of a football team that we were this year and how much pride we have in ourselves to come back and beat a highly talented football team.
Yeah, by far, it was definitely the Rowan game. You know, that's the game where, you know, we really played together, you know, I mean, stuck together with each other, so.
Running.
I think the memory that sticks out the most would be at a Rowan game. We came out at halftime. We were down by a lot. And in the first half, I had two fumbles inside the red zone, and I was kind of down on myself. And we joked about a lot about how I had a fumble every game or whatever, which isn't something proud for me to say. But I came out and I talked to Hardy, and I said to him, I said, we can't lose. You know, I got my fumble out of the way for next week. You know, we're going to win this game. And he looked at me and he's like, you know, kid, you're right. And that's just the way our season went.
Yeah, I would have to say the greatest feeling would be after the Rowan game, because it never really hit me. I mean, they were supposed to be this unbeatable team with these great players, these Division I transfers. And they came in, shot it up 20-0 right away. And then we came back and just put it right to them. And at the end of the game, just realizing what we accomplished and where we were going. I mean, it was one of the best feelings.
Message to my teammates, I think Bear, our captain, said it best, just to thank everyone. I mean, the amount of time and effort that all the guys put in throughout the year, the guys, the coaches, it's just amazing. We have a full-time school schedule, and we're practicing a couple hours every day and then meetings on top of that. I just want to thank everyone for playing their hearts out, playing together, not getting down at each other, and to the guys next year, good luck, and to everyone who played this year, thanks, and remember it always.
For the guys next year coming back, it's definitely not over. We still got a lot of hard work ahead of us. Everyone's going to be gunning for us, and for the seniors and all the guys that left, they were great leaders, and we appreciate everything that you've done for us, and good luck in whatever you choose to do in your life.
They're tearing it down now, but it's just as well. I haven't shown you everything a man can do. So stay with me, baby. I got plans for you. This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever.
On this field, a group of men led by men produced the second 12-win season in program history and finished second in the nation. I will remember their deeds forever.